Have you ever left a speaking engagement and thought, wow, that was a waste of time? I know we all do it. Wrong audience, nobody in the room. There's lots of things. Nobody converted. You made absolutely no money. You had no sales. There's lots of things that make us start to wonder why we took certain speaking engagements. And so I really wanted to talk to you today about how to know when to turn down a speaking gig. I'm Michelle Sism. I want to welcome you to Entrepreneurs Take Action. I think that one of the most powerful things you can do as an entrepreneur to get out there, get your credibility built, to get your visibility out there, to even getting new clients, the best thing you can do is be speaking. It truly changed the course of my business. And so along the way, I learned a lot of lessons. I showed up for a lot of audiences that consisted of me and one other person. I showed up for a lot of audiences that had no entrepreneurs in it. That's a shocker when I'm speaking directly to entrepreneurs. So, what do we do? I had to come up with some ideas on questions actually that we put together, and so that my team at this point, back when then it was me, but now it's my team kind of pre-qualifying speaking engagements. I do want to say, if you are super early on in your speaking career and you just need practice, you say yes to everything, right? Unless it's going to put you in harm's way, you say yes to speaking engagements. But it quickly becomes the opportunity where you need to be strategic about your speaking engagement. So that's what I want to do. And I want to tell you that I'm actually going to give you a checklist. I'll tell you how to download the checklist after a while that will take you through this entire process. But I'm going to walk you through, tell you exactly what we're looking at when we're deciding whether I should do a speaking gig or not. So the first thing we look at is the audience a fit? So who's going to be there? Are they my ideal audience? For me, it needs to be entrepreneurs, right? It could be solopreneurs, but I like it to be more well-defined as small business owners. And those are people who have been in business for a while. They have clients, customers. They have things happening, but they're still struggling, still trying to figure out how to make this business thing work. That's my ideal audience. You need to find out who's going to be in their room. Number two, how many people will be in their room? Now, listen, if this person is just doing this telesummit or speaking engagement for the very first time and they tell you, wow, I'm going to have 100 people there. They probably are not going to have what they tell you. And actually, kind of rule of thumb is half of what they tell you will actually be there. However, if it's a networking event or an event that's been going on for a while, or maybe it's a telesummit that you're going to be part of that has been occurring for multiple times, then they should have a real feel for how many will really be in their audience. Number three, is this the first time that the host has hosted this event? Have they has hosted other events that are similar? And so when we look at, sometimes for me, opportunities, speaking gigs are paid opportunities where I may be paying for a speaking spot, then I really want to make sure that this host knows what they're doing, right? Number four, what is their marketing plan? Are they coming to me because they feel like I'm the expert and I'm going to fill their room for them? And that happens, people. So you need to make sure that they have a plan to fill that speaking engagement and that it doesn't just fall on your shoulders. Obviously, we're going to promote that I'm going to be there, right? You're going to talk about what you're up to, but you should not promise to fill their event for them. They should be filling that event. Number five, what are my marketing requirements? So a lot of times you'll do something and the agreement is you can come speak, but you need to send out an email to your list saying you're coming. You need to send out 10 social media tweets, Facebook posts, whatever that looks like. So you just need to know what are your requirements. And then the number six is to actually look and see that it fits into your marketing calendar. So if you as things start to grow and you start to get lots of speaking engagements, you want to be careful that if you've got marketing requirements for each of these speaking engagements, you don't put them too close together. You need to be able to market them without confusing your audience. So you want to be sure that you have a marketing calendar and that you know when things are happening. Number seven, can I make an offer? And can it be a paid offer or does it need to be a free offer? So a combo question. Can I make an offer? And can it be a paid offer or does it have to be a free offer? Number 8, if I make a paid offer, do I have to pay the host a commission? That is very normal. When I sell info products, for example, from a stage, I am usually required to give the host 40 to 50% of the revenues from those sales. It kind of just depends on the agreement. So you want to get clear on what can your offer be and then whether you have a requirement to pay the host anything. So there you go. 8 items that you should be looking at when you're deciding if you should turn down a speaking gig. And I told you that I would give you this in the download so that you could have the checklist and you give it to your team and they should go in and do a couple of things before they even ask you if you want to be involved. They should be looking at, you know, who's the audience? How big is it? Is it a fit? Does it work in the marketing calendar? Once my team knows those questions, that works, then they come to me and say, so look, we have this opportunity. It meets the criteria in the beginning. So do you want to take a look at it? Okay, and that's what you should be doing. All right, so for that download, you can go to decisiveminds.com/turn-down. decisiveminds.com/turn-down. And that's going to give you the checklist for you to better be strategic with your speaking gigs. This is Michelle Sism saying be decisive, and I'll see you next time on Entrepreneurs Take Action. Bye-bye.